Welcome everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Microsoft Graph Toolkit. Microsoft Graph Toolkit, which comes with a lot of web components. Today, I'm going to explore how to use those web components in a simple Node.js web application. Come on, let's see. Let's open a Windows PowerShell to create a simple Node.js Express web application. So I'm creating a new folder for our project name MGT Demo App. Then I'm navigating to the project. Okay, let's open our project folder and now Visual Studio Code. Now we have opened our project folder and our Visual Studio Code. So now I'm navigating back to PowerShell for initializing our project folder to Node.js app. So enter npm init and leave the name as same as project folder. So I'm resizing it. So leave the name as it is the project folder. So now entering the description as sample Node.js web app to explore Microsoft Graph Toolkit web components. Now entry point will be server.js. So this command leave same as it is, keywords leave as it is, author I'm entering my name and my Twitter handle. So license as it is and yes. Yeah, now we have created a Node.js app. So just see the package.json. Okay, we are going to convert this Node.js app to Express application. So npm install save Express. So this will install the Express node module to our Node.js project. Okay, you can see the node modules folder is created in our project and then the package.json is updated with Express. Okay, so you can see now the server.js as a entry point. So I'm going to create a new file called server.js. So now we have created a server.js. After creating the file, I have added a snippet which calls index.html as a default file when the application starts run. And also we have mentioned index.html under the views folder. So I am creating views folder and then adding the index.html as a new file under the views. I already have the basic HTML snippet. So I am adding that in index.html. Now we will run our application. For that, we have to add one more line in package.json. Yeah, just I'm adding start node server.js because this is a entry point. Then open PowerShell and then add npm start and enter. Then open a browser and then type localhost 2020 because we have used 2020 as a port in server.js. The basic HTML works fine now. So we will start inserting the Microsoft Graph Toolkit components to the HTML and test it. Let's resizing the browser and VS Code side by side. Let's add a script element to load MGT loader file, which is used to load all Microsoft Graph Toolkit providers and components, which is open source and provided by Microsoft Graph team. Let's get the script URL directly from Microsoft Docs under Microsoft Graph Toolkit from Microsoft Graph API reference. Copy the script location and paste it in our file. Then add mgt-msal-provider element to enable our application to take care on authentication and acquiring tokens using msal.js. Add additional properties for client ID, login type, and then scopes. To get a client ID, I'm navigating to Azure App Registration Portal. From there, copy the client ID from the app which I have already created and paste it in next to the client ID attribute. I have a separate video for creating the app from app registration. I have given in the video's description. Please check that later. And then add redirect next to the login type. There are two options available, redirect and pop-up. I'm using redirect here. And then add user.read in scope so that MSAL provider authorizes the user to access the specific object based on the scope. Check out Microsoft Graph API reference from Microsoft Docs to know more about the Microsoft Graph Toolkit providers and components. I'm using the MGT login control here to support the login functionality to the application. Then refresh the browser, we'll see the sign in button. Click the sign in button. Now we will redirect to the login page and then to scope authorization page. Login control also has its own scope. Based on that, it will ask us to accept the scope. Click accept button. It redirects us to index.html with the logged in user information. This is very cool, isn't it? Now we will test another component called mgt-person and then add person query parameter. Within the parameter, add me so that it returns the current user profile image. Save it and refresh the browser. Yeah, now we'll see profile image. If you want to view the name of the current user, add show name attribute, save it and refresh the page. We'll see the name next to the profile image. If you want to mail also, add show mail attribute, save it and refresh the page. We'll see profile image, name and email. If you want to view another user information, change the person query parameter. After refreshing the browser, we won't get that user information because we don't have permission to view it. For that, add one more scope called user.read.all to the MSAL provider. This scope allows us to read other user profile through Microsoft Graph. Refresh the page, you can see read all users full profiles. Click accept. Now we can see the username and email here. Next, we try people component. For that, I'm typing mgt-people. This is used to display a group of people or contacts. Refreshing the page, it displays the people by using their photos or initials. Just hovering that, it asks me for another permission scope, view your basic profile. Click accept. We can see the profile code when we hover that particular user. By default, it will display the most frequent contacts for the signed in user. We can restrict or show maximum number of people in the component by using the showmax property. Showmax, after entering 5, we can see the 5 users. So there are totally 10 users available. So here, for showing the 5 users and plus 5. So if I'm changing to 10, we can see total all 10 users in the people component. Next, we'll try people picker component. For that, I'm using mgt-people-picker. And then I'm refreshing the page. Now the browser shows the text box for searching the people. This web component is used to search for a specified number of people and render the list of results via the Microsoft Graph. By default, the component will search for all people from our Office 365 tenant. Next one, we'll try agenda component. For that, I'm using mgt-agenda. So once refresh the page, it asks me to accept the read calendar events. This web component is used to represent say events in a user or group calendar. I'm adding additional attribute group by day. This is used to group all the events based on the day. At present, I didn't have any events for the current day, so it displays nothing. So I'm going to Outlook and the calendar, and then I'm creating an event for today. New event, here I'm adding demo event and then select today and inviting the attendees. Click send button. So the event is created. Now go back to our page and the first page. Yes, now we can see event for the current day. I am using group by day so that it displays the events by grouping. So next component is a task component. So once adding mgt task, I have to refresh the page. So once I refresh the page, I can see by all tasks. So before that, it asks me a permission to read all groups. By default, the web component, each web component has its own permission scope so that it asks us to accept it. We can see the list of all tasks is assigned to me. We can also create a new task from this web component. For the click add task, entering add new task, select sample plan and then select for next day and click plus button. So it will add a new to-do item in my bucket. So it's showing read and write all groups because it needs your permission to write the items in the task. We didn't select any assigned to person so that it's not displaying the newly added item here. So now we'll add one more task, my new task, and then select the plan from the bucket group and then select the date and select my name as a assigned to person. Click plus. Now we'll see the newly added task here. So instead of having all the scopes and particular command, we can also specify the scopes in the MSAL provider. Initially, signing in itself tasks the all the permissions whatever required for this page. Let's hide the components and we'll see our lost component called get component. So I'm using the get mgt-get resource slash groups and scopes as a group.3.all and version is v1.2 I'm using. The template element which used to display the HTML once the endpoint response is successful, by default it scores under the template the data type default. So it renders the HTML based on the response. This data file which is used to looping response array. So value which is returned from the response. So I'm using group of value and within the li I'm using group.displayName. Saving this page and refresh the browser. So before that I'm opening the console. Refreshing the page, we can see all the groups available across my tenant. From the developer tool under the networks, we can see the groups. Once I'm selecting groups, we can see the value which is we have used in the template element. Under that, selecting the display name, you can see. So we can access any property from this group's endpoint. We can access any graph endpoint by using this get web component. Please subscribe and click the bell icon to get more videos and stay tuned. And also give your valuable feedback on this video. And don't forget to click the like button. Thank you for watching.